If you are into 3D printing, you know that mastering overhangs can be a real game changer. Whether you are a beginner or a seasoned, understanding how to handle these challenges can significantly improve your print quality and expand your design possibilities. Hi, Remy here, and in this video, we are tackling one of the trickiest challenges in 3D printing, steep overhangs. One of the key techniques is adding chamfers or fillets to your designs to reduce the severity of overhangs. There's another option in OrcaSlicer called Make Overhangs Printable. But this will change the shape of the model. If these are not an option, lowering the layer height or adding a modifier with three or more walls can also help. So stick around as we dive into these techniques, tips and tricks to conquer steep overhangs and take your 3D printing skills to the next level. Let's get started. Now let's see adding a chamfer. This is a test model, so I need to add a chamfer to this angle over here. So I'll click on this line and then click on the chamfer button over here. And 1 mm is not enough, so I have to add more because I need to cover this entire area for it to make it printable. So this would be 10. So 10 is also not enough, as you can see this particular area needs another chamfer, otherwise it will be steep overhang. So we'll increase this area. So we'll click on over here and click another chamfer. And this time we'll add a smaller one, let's say 0.2. This looks okay. Now this will be printable, but if you see, it has changed the shape completely. Now let's see adding a fillet. So again, I need to add fillet to this angle over here. So I'll click on this line and then click fillet. So 1 mm is not enough over here. We need to add more. So somewhere like this. So this will be now printable. If you see over here again, the shape of the model is changed. Now this is a test model. We are not going to design such thing, but if at all we have to design that has a requirement like this, then adding a modifier or lowering the layer height at this particular area, so from this area up till here, this particular area, okay, can help by adding modifier or lowering the layer height. Otherwise we need to add support over here for this to get printed. Now let's find out steep overhang angle in OrcaSlicer. So we'll select the model, click on this measurement tool and click on this edge line, this line and this line. So this will give us the steep overhang angle. So here for this model it says 100 degree. Now we'll see few test print with 105 and 100 degree overhang angle. In this test print, the overhang angle is 105 degree and the other parameters are mentioned as follows. Extra parameter on overhang is set to true. Ensure vertical shell thickness is set to all. Reverse on order is set to false. These are the default settings, this 1, 2 and 3. These are default settings, no change in them. As you can see here in this test print, it isn't good enough. The lines are just hanging in midair. Later in this video, we'll go through these three settings in OrcaSlicer. This is the same test print as before, where overhang angle is 105. Here, the difference is I have added a modifier with three walls. This is the same test model as before with overhang angle as 105. The difference here is I have used variable layer height. Enabling these values, whether you enable or disable this value, doesn't make any difference. This is another test print where overhang angle is 100 degree and the other settings are set to false. Extra parameter on overhang, ensure walls, vertical shell thickness and reverse order, these settings are set to false. This is the same test model as before where overhang angle is 100 degree, but these two options are enabled. Reverse on order, whether it is enabled or disabled, I don't see any difference. So if we enable these two, we get a much better print for a 100 degree angle. In this test print, addition is modifier. I have added a modifier here with 3 walls. I don't see any improvement by adding a modifier. In this test print, the modifier is increased to 4 walls. There is slight improvement over here. If you see these areas, there is slight improvement, but not in the acceptable range. Here is the final test print for the same model where overhang angle is 100 degree. And the difference here is variable layer height is used. If you see in both the test print with 100 and 105 overhang angle, adding a variable layer height increases the print quality. This is the last test print where make overhangs printable is set to true in Orca Slicer. As you can see here, it has completely changed the model shape. This comparison is of adding modifier. The last two test print are 100 degree angle and this one is 105 degree angle. Between these two, as you can see, going below 105 degree overhang angle by adding modifier does not help, as you can clearly see here. So up to 105 or above, I would say adding modifier will improve the print test quality without adding any support. Here is a comparison with variable layer height for 100 and 105 degree angle. In these two, this one is much smoother with 105 and 100 and with 100 degree angle, it a little bit droopy on the edges. Now we shall see the Orca Slicer settings. There are 4 settings that we have to look for: make overhangs printable, extra parameters on overhang, reverse on order, and ensure vertical shell thickness. The first 3 you'll find under quality, and scroll down and under overhang. Here you have make overhangs printable, extra parameter on overhang, and reverse on order. The last one is ensure vertical shell thickness will be under strength and advance over here. Ensure vertical shell thickness. And there are 4 options: none to disable, critical only, moderate, and all. In all of my testament, I've set it to all. Now we shall see the settings and their changes in Orca Slicer. We'll start with ensure vertical shell thickness, which you can find under strength and under advance over here. Default is all, so we'll slice this model. As you can see, this grayish blue color line, these are the vertical shell thickness. So we'll disable this and see the change. Slice the model. As you can see now, those lines are gone. So we'll re-enable. Slice the model. And these are the lines where it maintains the vertical shell thickness. Now let's see extra parameter on overhang. You can find this under quality, overhangs, and over here, extra parameters on overhang. Extra parameters on overhang is enabled by default. So let's slice the model and see if there is any difference. Now I'll lower down just to the layer where it starts for overhang, right over here. As you can see over here, there is no difference. I will just raise the layer up here. There isn't any difference. So for this particular test print, where the angle is 105, doesn't make any change. So I will load another test model where the angle is 100. So this model has an overhang angle of 100. So we'll slice this model and see. So in this model, we can see that there are some extra parameters laid on top of the bottom vertical layers. So we'll lower it down to the same position where the overhang starts, right over here. In this model, we can see that there is some extra parameters laid over here. So we'll lower this slider. So the test print starts with these extra parameters. Now it starts with the inner wall and then the outer wall. So ideally this should help in overhang where the outer wall will touch to the inner wall and there is no air gap between these two lines. So it will help in sticking these two lines together. So as you go up, we should see the same. Over here also, we have the same. But like I said, enabling this option, I don't see a big difference in the quality compared to modifier and variable layer height. Now let's see, make overhangs printable. You can find under quality and then overhang and over here. This is visible by default, so we need to enable this. It will give a warning here saying that the model's shape will be changed. So we'll enable and then slice the model. As you can see now over here, this has changed the shape in order to make overhang printable. Now we'll see add modifier. So you select your model. In this case, my test print is this. So right click and select add modifier. You can load your own by clicking on this. I normally select the cube and do the required adjustment, whatever. So over here, you have to make a note that the modifier should cover outside the area, not just inside, but the outside area. So we'll change, we'll align this first. As you can see, the modifier is all around the actual test print. So this is how it should be. The modifier must be covering the entire print area, the outside as well as shown over here, and not just the area where it is required. So it should be like this. Do not do like this, where it covers only this area, because if you take a print, then these walls will be printed in between. So let me show this to you. So I will increase this wall and slice the model. As you can see now over here, this is happening due to the modifier. So the modifier should be covering the entire area. So I will go back over here. So it should be like this. Okay. So now when you take a test print with three walls and slice it, so this particular area, now it will have three walls. We'll go below down below. See here, if you have here now you have two walls, and as you come to that particular area where the modifier was added, you will have three walls, 1, 2, 3, right up to the end where the modifier ends. Over here, this is the end of the modifier. So until here you have three walls. So if you go up, you will have just two walls. Now let's see variable layer height. Load the model. In my case, I'm loading this test model. Click on this model and then click the variable layer height. Right hand side, you will find this slider. This slider denotes the number of layers where you can add the variable layer height. With the left mouse button, layer height is decreased, and the right mouse button, their layer height is increased. So click and drag the way you want, either up or down, depending on your requirement. In my case, I will start from this position and go upwards until this position. So I will start right over here. So I will click the left mouse button and go upwards. So here I will see now by slicing how the sliced model will look. We will slice this. Over here, this looks okay, but here it is gone little high. So I will reduce this layer height over here. We'll go back, and with the right mouse button, I will click and reduce it. So we'll slice it again and see. Okay, this is much better, but I still need to reduce here. Go back. Slice. Okay, looks much better. Here also I will try to reduce this. So over here, left mouse button, and now slice. Yeah, this is much better. Now if you see, it has added more number of layers. The layer height is less over here. By lowering the layer height, the chances of the top layer laying down on the bottom layer are more. So you have a more surface area for the top layer to lay down. So this way, the overhang will get a better chance of printing. My personal preference is to go with add modifier, then variable layer height. As I know that anything which has a steep overhang angle of 105 and above, I can manage with add modifier. If it's below that, I need to go with variable layer height. That's my personal preference, because with variable layer height, where the layer line are less, you have a question of strength at this given area. Let me know in the comments if you like or dislike this video. Thanks for watching. God bless and stay safe.